Many people complain about their mother-in-law, but not me. Mine, she's extraordinary. Not only she's a fantastic person, but she's a phenomenal chef, truly. She's the kind of woman who can walk into a kitchen with nothing but onions, chilies, and corns, and turn it into a feast. Her pozole soup is legendary in our family. Her cooking has carried us through birthdays, holidays, and those everyday meals that somehow turn into memories. But a few years ago, something started to change. The flavor in her dishes became uneven, sometimes too salty, sometimes too sweet. We laughed, and I teased her, gently calling her La Reina de la Sal, or the Queen of Salt. But as a nurse scientist who studies the senses, I knew that the change that I was noticing in her cooking could mean more. So I paid close attention. What if something as ordinary as too much salt was actually a clue, a warning sign? And in her case, it was. I tested her sense of smell using a basic test. And sure enough, her sense of smell was diminished. That small change led to a cascade of medical evaluations. Eventually, we learned that she had frontal temporal lobe dementia. The same condition that has recently come into public conversation with actor Bruce Willis. It wasn't just her cooking that had changed. It was her brain sending us an early signal. What happened in my family connects with what I study every day. I am a chemosensory scientist and a nurse practitioner. That means that I lead a laboratory that studies how diseases alter the senses of taste and smell, and how these changes are tied to chronic conditions, to memory, nutrition, brain health, and well-being. I have spent my academic career working to bring these overlooked senses into the center of healthcare. Like my mother-in-law's case suggests, if we ignore assessing the senses of taste and smell, we aren't getting the full picture. We are missing critical parts of the clinical presentation. Consider this, we test vision, hearing, and blood pressure. But how often do we test the sense of smell? This isn't a theory. It is something I have seen with patients and in my own family. For some, the very first sign of trouble isn't a tremor or a memory lapse. It can be smell loss. And noticing that change gave our family something precious, time. Time to prepare, time to understand, and time to stand beside her in ways we have missed and ignored it. In my family, smell loss was a sign that something more profound was happening in my mother-in-law's brain. But what does the science say when we look at thousands of people, not just one home? In a large study published in 2025 in the Journal of the American Medical Association, entitled Olfactory Deficits and Mortality in Older Adults, scientists followed more than 2,500 participants in Sweden for over a decade. At the start, everyone took a smell test using scented pens. Literally, it's markers that you can sniff that have common odors in it, like coffee, rose, smoke, and gas. The results were clear. The more odors a person missed, the greater the risk of having a serious health decline and increased mortality. This wasn't a single mistake, it was a pattern. Each missed order was part of a larger story. But why does that happen? Part of it came down to nutrition and frailty. But the strongest link wasn't just physical decline, it was dementia. When the researchers dug deeper, they found that dementia explained nearly 25% of the increased risk. And it's not just in Sweden. In the United States, a 2019 study published in the Annals of Internal Medicine entitled Relationship Between Poor Olfaction and Mortality Among Dwelling Older Adults followed over 2,200 participants for up to 13 years. Those who had a poor smell at the start were nearly 50% more likely to experience a serious health decline within 10 years than those that had good smell. And among people who felt perfectly fine at the start, that risk jumped even higher to 62%. Think about that. Missing a smell wasn't just about missing aromas. It was often an early clue that something bigger was unfolding in the brain. Now I see that some of you are already thinking about your own sense of smell. And I want to be clear, smell loss is common. When allergies, sinus infections, COVID, lots of different things might affect your sense of smell. And most people, when smell changes, won't develop dementia. That's good news. What matters is this. If you notice a change, especially one that's sudden and doesn't go away, mention it to your doctor. That's it. No panic, just mention it. The same way that you'll report a change in your vision or your hearing. This research gives us awareness, and awareness, that's empowering. It is about adding one more tool to our health toolkit, one more way that we can take proactive steps towards our health. And that's actually good news. And yet, in most clinics, smell is never tested. The sense of smell isn't a secondary nice to have. It is one of the body's earliest lines of defense. If you can smell smoke or gas, you might be in danger. If food has no flavor, you might lose your appetite or overeat. If you can smell your morning coffee or the shirt of someone you love, you could lose anchors of joy that help keep you connected to life. Smell is also communication. Long before we had language, we had scent. Parents often recognize their newborns by smell. Partners sometimes notice subtle shift in scent before doctors detect illness. So what does it mean when one of our oldest, most primal senses goes silent? It means that the brain might be whispering before it ever shouts. Loss of smell isn't just about flavors or fragrance. It can be the body's first alarm that something deeper is unfolding. We saw this during COVID. Overnight, the world learned that loss of smell wasn't just annoying. It was an important early sign of infection. And here's another truth. In neurodegenerative conditions, such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease, smell loss can appear years before motor or cognitive symptoms. In other dementias, such as frontal temporal lobe dementia, the picture is less clear, but changes in smell might still be an early sign. And yet, smell is too often treated as a secondary footnote. But it isn't. It is one of the body's most overlooked sensory clues. What if when you go to the doctor, it included a smell test, just like you have a vision chart or blood pressure cuff? It takes minutes, but it could flag risk years before other symptoms appear. Until that day, we have to pay attention to the smell shifts ourselves. If you or someone you love notices a sudden change in their sense of smell, don't brush it off. Treat it like you would when a change of vision or memory. A signal worth checking. These days, we are my mother-in-law's taste testers in the kitchen. I might never master my mother-in-law's pozole, but today we can still enjoy her cooking, watching her add a pinch of this and a pinch of that, knowing that this time is precious. That gift was only possible because we noticed a salty clue in her cooking early. So smell loss isn't trivial. It is a quiet message from the brain. And when we listen, when we act, it changes how we prepare, how we care, and how we hold on to the people we love. Because sometimes the smallest changes, the ones hiding in plain sight or right under our nose, make the biggest difference. Thank you.